Good morning. Today is Tuesday, November 17, 2020. Rejection of MEA's response on Pakistan dossier regarding India's state sponsorship of terrorism. Pakistan categorically rejects the Indian Ministry of External Affairs' denial of the irrefutable evidence provided by Pakistan on Indian state sponsorship of terrorism. Fully exposed, India has typically resorted to sophistry, obfuscation and refabrication. Bland denials and regurgitation of old litany of charges, however, will not change facts. The dossier presented by Pakistan extensively documents India's active planning, promoting, aiding, abetting, financing and execution of terrorist activities against Pakistan. Since 2001, Pakistan has faced more than 19,000 terrorist attacks on its soil and suffered 83,000 casualties. The direct economic losses have been upward of US$126 billion. As a result of India's sponsorship of terrorism, from across our borders, Pakistan continues to suffer immensely. Meanwhile, India has mischievously masqueraded as a victim of terrorism and sought to mislead the international community by hypocritically leveling terrorism-related allegations against Pakistan. It has also conducted false flag operations in IHK and inside India to malign Pakistan. That facade has now been removed and the world can see the real face of India, one blackened by its decades-long state terrorism in IHK and state-sponsored terrorism and destabilization efforts in Pakistan. The most familiar and undeniable face of India's state sponsorship of terrorism against Pakistan is Commander Kulbhushan Jadhav, caught red-handed in March 2016. His complicity in subversion, sabotage and terrorism in Pakistan is part of the incontrovertible evidence against India. The world is also familiar with saffron terror orchestrated and unleashed by the RSS BJP zealots against Muslims in India and against Pakistan. Masterminds of Mecca Musjid, Ajmera Dargah, and Samjida Express terrorist cases, like Swami A.C. Menand, have been granted full state protection and acquitted in complete travesty of justice after having confessed to India's National Investigation Agency, NIA. Open threats to Pakistan by Indian civilian and military leaders, India's sinister design to subvert China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, CPC, and public statements by noted Indian politicians and senior security officials on teaching Pakistan a lesson through use of terrorism constitute further incriminating evidence. The presence of ISIL and AKAs in India, as highlighted in recent UN reports, indicate that India is emerging as a hotbed of UN-designated international terrorist organizations and posing a great risk to the region. Recent revelations by Fincen Files illustrate how India uses its financial system for money laundering and other illegal activities such as terrorism financing, brazenly and with impunity. Use of terrorism as an instrument of state policy by India makes it culpable under international law, UN sanctions regime, and international counter-terrorism conventions. It is the collective responsibility of the world community to hold India to account and take practical steps to proceed against the Indian nationals involved in patronage of terrorist entities. We also expect the UN counter-terrorism bodies to proceed on the basis of concrete evidence provided by Pakistan and urge India to renounce use of terrorism as an instrument of state policy. The UN must also play its part in dismantling of the Indian terrorist infrastructure, details of which have been provided in the dossier. Thanks for watching Newstime 9. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel, like, comment and share this video.